Fire investigators still working to determine what sparked the blaze that took the lives of six people inside a row home in East Baltimore.
Flames ripped through a total of four homes early this morning in the 2300 block of Homewood Avenue. Among those killed, three children. 11 News reporter Kai Reed has the latest.
A makeshift memorial outside of the burned out homes has grown steadily in the hours since the fire that took six lives.
It was just a smile.
Neighbors knew the victim's home as a place to find a friendly smile and a helping hand.
Ms. Satterfield was a beautiful person. God knows she was beautiful. She was a school teacher. And I used to go down there when all the children used to surround her and everything, right? She was a beautiful person. I just couldn't believe it. It's something you can't believe.
According to family members, the six victims include two grandparents, a mother, and her three children, ages 9, 3, and 1.
They were just pretty and beautiful children. And to see six bodies to die in a fire around the holidays, and it's just overwhelming for me.
All friends and family, and that's the strong thing we have right now. And the God blessing, that's all we have right now. And just hold on. That's all we can do. And just hold and keep each other close.
This is a community that's experienced this kind of tragedy before. Several people died in a house fire in the neighborhood 3 years ago. Neighborhood church St. Anne's once again provided a refuge for the families mourning the loss of their neighbors and displaced from their own homes.
As the day went on, more and more people came from the neighborhood and from their extended families as the word got around that they were here. And so we were very glad to welcome them and help them to come and greet the families.
The two displaced families are also receiving assistance from the Red Cross, a place to stay, and financial assistance to help replace all they've lost.
Clothing, food, just whatever they need for the next couple of days, and then our caseworkers will work with those families in the days and weeks to come.
Well, the windy weather conditions made fighting the fire very difficult. Firefighters even had to evacuate at one point until conditions improved. Now, it's not clear at this point if the house had any working smoke detectors.